Well, hey everybody, it's HeapCVA. Welcome to my channel. Thanks so much for coming by. Really appreciate it as usual. Makes me get up in the morning early and go to bed late. And I'm not just saying that. All right. Welcome to Notruf 112 or emergency call 112. Haven't been here for a while. Thought I'd fire it back up. There was, in fact, an update for the between Emerge NYC and this. I'm getting the patches and the updates confused. On the 6th of March, in fact, the beta got the patch. I'm not sure, and I can't move over and look now because of the cursor's locked to the screen. I'm looking at the notes on the other screen. Whether or not the stable version of the game has gotten their version of the patch since. There's not very many things on here. That's why I kind of put it off a little bit. I'll get the game going while we're talking about it. I kept thinking something was going to pop out on Emerge NYC that didn't on the timeline that I had for it. I'm not blaming that on Flip Switch by any stretch. So it's good to go back to this. I'm going to get this video taken care of, and then I'm going to do a 911 first responders video because it's been quite a while since that. And then I'll go back to some of the other games in my library that you guys have not ever seen. And maybe by the time I go around the block a few times, Emerge NYC will come back with something new. Like I said, I would expect some things to happen by the end of the month because I'm an optimist. Does that mean I'm going to be right? Not a chance, man. But you know, I'm going to stay optimistic about this game till further notice. Am I going to jump up and down and say, everybody get your checkbooks out and get ready to buy this thing right now? I can't do that. Everybody's going to have to take this on its own merits with what you got going on in your life. But my answer has been so far to the, this is still not fixed, to this issue in the last couple of questions that have been asked of me. I'm telling everybody to wait to the end of the month. Let's see what happens. Let's see if multiplayer gets up and running, because that's a big deal that they take care of some of the things that are happening with all the additions they made to the new map, which are killing frame rates, and see where that goes before anybody whips their checkbook out. Because if your computer's on the margin anyway of being able to do this or not, that just makes it more likely that you won't be able to do anything with it. And that's not what you're trying to do, and that's not why you spend your hard-earned money. So let's talk about this while we're waiting for a call. Oh, we're going to go to a call right now. I have a car fire. I can do that. So we'll run downstairs. I don't like those stairs. They hold you like you're handcuffed by your ankles. They could use a few less doors. A little bit of jumpiness today. Don't know what that's all about. You know, I've just learned to take it one day at a time. I don't honestly know what resolution I'm playing this at. I don't think it's the highest. I rarely do that, even on a good day. So, well, we're going to a car fire. But anyway, the first thing on the patch notes list is a bug was fixed where improper starting of new games after loading a save game. I don't know what that means. I think we can all kind of figure it out, but you never know. That didn't take long to get to. That's probably one of the closest responses I've ever had. Now let's see who gets the hose line. I do. Rapid attack hose. I was kind of hoping he'd say that word. It's been a while, man. That's not what I grabbed. Go away, for crying out loud. They said they fixed this whole aiming thing. We'll have to wait and see. Seems like, you know, he's got it almost in his hip pocket. But, I mean, they may hold things differently in the German version of the fire service than we do in the U.S., so... I know there were some issues with loading save games. It's been an issue for quite a while. They thought they had it taken care of. Obviously, they didn't if there was a bug that needed to be squashed. Number two, the bug fix. Incorrect graphics in and around the fire station. Personally, I don't think I've noticed. But I don't know in what context that is. It's not... There's not enough information for me to know if it was something I saw or didn't see. It's been a while since I played the game, but I played it since the March 6th update. In fact, I was going to do a video and got sidetracked by both Emerge NYC and working on that mod that I'm trying to give some time to that's going to be for 911 first responders. I think the graphics there look pretty good. There must have been something that caught their eye because they made a concerted effort to fix it. Third bug fix. Using some resolutions resulted in missing OK/cancel buttons on the fire configuration. And escape can also be used to exit now or quit the game. It was also always a couple of button pushes. I'll probably continue to do the same thing unless it turns that corner on me on its own. Another bug fix. You were able to store items from the wrong side of the vehicle. I never tried that, but that's interesting, and I'm glad that somebody caught it and they could fix it. I never saw that. Maybe it's people that didn't follow the instructions. Not really, but I mean, I don't know. I've never had the issue, you know, like in Emerge NYC, sometimes when you would open a compartment door on one side of the fire engine, a door on this side would open because it would go all the way through the vehicle body. I guess, and I didn't even realize it, that this particular, and I can call this a game, was doing the same thing. I had not experienced that. I've just been lucky, apparently. Here's a word that everybody wants to hear more often, especially in beta versions of games. Optimization. Da-da-da-da. Love optimization. That means they're working hard on polish for a given part of the software. The occlusion culling and LOD, which is line of distance. Oops, woo. Boom. Another call right off the get-go. Oh, please don't tell me I'm going to get stuck on there. I didn't. I reminded myself, turn around, go the other way, you'll be fine. So we're going to get on the little fire unit. Kind of bumpy stairs today. That could be my game. It could be, or it could be the game, it could be my video card for all I know. Sometimes, you know, if you've been doing stuff all day, it kind of, you almost need to restart your computer to get everything to kind of settle down. So good, the driver's driving, that's all good. Occlusion is another thing that's a part of giving good visual to you, items in the software, like vehicles and trees and stuff like that, and how they shade and they change color, and as you look at them from different angles, they change a little bit. And then line of distance, that one's pretty much self-explanatory. You know, and we have noticed that you don't see very far in the grand scheme of things. Is this good enough? I think you have to be in the square there, Sparky. Nope, guess not. See, I was yelling at him for nothing. Is he going to get out? Oh, he panicked me for a minute. Man, I almost forgot what the button pushes are for this game. It's been so long. Okay, looking through the... this, but it's still a little squirrely. Yeah, that's probably a tough deal to fix as we talk about something that... but I do like that the hose is rolling up instead of just creating 500 miles of spaghetti. That's always good. Another optimization is a reworked occlusion culling of buildings. Again, same thing. It goes to the textures that they put on things to make it look real instead of the wireframe that's underneath it. And occlusion is just one of the things that makes things appear more realistic. And they've been working on it, obviously. You know, when we talked about Emerge NYC, I talked about wireframes and polygons and high poly counts kill your graphics systems. And there may have been some of that here, and they're trying to find them. It's almost like bug hunting. Find the things that maybe the poly counts are too high and eliminate some of the polygons that don't necessarily make the item look bad, but help graphics and rendering be more efficient. So next one down on the list. Game will now pause if the application loses its focus. I got to tell you, I'm more likely to lose focus than the game is, but that's, number one, it's something I haven't even seen, but number two, I appreciate that it stops instead of, you know, keeps running and you run off a cliff or something, I guess. I can't think of a time where the game is all of a sudden just, maybe that's why some of your co-firefighters on various calls will just stop looking in the direction of the incident and just kind of look off into left field. Could be that. Without seeing a picture to understand it, all like we can all do is guess. The fact that they're on top of it means it was something obvious to them and they're hoping it got fixed. And finally, and I've talked about this by accident, is looking aiming has been reworked without the use of, I think that says IK. I have no idea what IK is. Maybe somebody can explain that to me in the comments. I'd really appreciate that. That's one that's beyond me. I thought it had to do with the use of the nozzle. And maybe it does, and that's the shorthand for what kind of nozzle you're using. I don't remember it being called that. We'll have to look when we get off the rig here, because now I'm curious. It's nice that we've had two calls while I'm talking, and it's only been 12 minutes. That's all good stuff. Get out of the rig. I'm going to go check this out real quick. Like, what is that called? That's called a rapid attack hose. So that's not anything like what I was thinking of. So you got me. I thought I knew what he was talking about. Maybe I don't. Oh, well. One of these days, while I'm thinking about it, and we're waiting for the next call, we have to go over here. This other vehicle here is actually drivable in the game. I used to know the phraseology of what these different components were that you add to this truck and what it was called. Do you think I can think of that right this minute? No. I will remember it right after. Oh, we're going to another little small conflagration. Okie doke. Which way am I going? All right. I'll remember what I was going to say right after I stop recording. That's just my luck, man. I'm telling you. It's a whole other explanation someday down the road. So that is the short list of patch notes for 1.0.6696B. There's a heck of a lot of numbers in that. And, you know, now hopefully to eat up the balance of time for this particular version of this emergency call 112 video, we can get us some good calls and get a better picture of anything we hadn't seen before that has been dealt with. A lot of small fires today. To pick things apart as usual and kind of know what to expect when the game gets out of its beta phase and into a real release. It'll happen soon. Sooner than later, anyway. Come on, just open up. There you go. Oh man, somebody lit the teeter-totter on fire. That's egregious. You gotta get right over here to apparently put that out. But we did it and saved the teeter-totter. That's what we call, I call it where I come from. You might call it something else. Seesaw is another word, but in Southern California, it was teeter-totter. And I think that had more to do with the people that were on it than the vehicle, the plate equipment itself, but that's how that goes. Excuse me. Woo. Changing the weather. It's real dry. It's been in the 90s after freezing my rear end off every night and most of the day having, you know, at least a flannel shirt on, and now I'm in shorts and flip-flops, and I still wear a t-shirt. I don't wear tank tops. That's not pretty. Sorry. But my body has to get used to the weather because it takes all the humidity out of the air. We are kind of in a desert. Whether we want to realize it or admit it or not, we are. So while you're waiting for us to get back to the fire station, I'm going to go ahead and freeze time. I'll stop talking. When we get the next emergency, you'll hear me come back up as the alarm goes off. So hopefully we see you in just a second. All right, guys, here we go. Like I said, looks like another day of small fires. Wow, it's weird. I was watching everybody get stuck on that thing, and I think I had the entire staffing of the fire station stuck on those stairs. But unfortunately, while I have it on video, I promised you I wasn't going to talk until the bell went off, so it has no description to it, but I might use it for the thumbnail for the upload to YouTube. It always helps if you get on the right piece of fire equipment. So here we go again. It is interesting where the fire apparatus, what lane that it utilizes as it responds to the incident. And I guess it's a difference between the way in the U.S. we address everything as the emergency, and maybe they don't quite see it the same way, or that traffic has more right to the streets than what we do is say go to the right. All right, where's my air pack? I gotta put a thing out first, really? Oh, can't they see the smoke? There's this circle way out there. This must be really heavy, judging by how he's running. Because we may get there sometime today. Boink. All right. They love to jog. Oh, for crying out loud. Where's the police officer to help us with traffic control when you really need him? Sorry, that's not very nice. All right. These. Fortunately, we don't have to go as far. Well, I can pretty much say that the bus stop's going to be... Well, it doesn't actually burn down. Thanks for opening the door for me, big guy. Now, see, I'm not pointing that way. I'm actually moving my mouse there. And look how he's standing sideways. That's interesting. I'm not thinking that is actually fixing the issue. It's funny how a fog stream doesn't really get a handle on the fire. If you don't use a straight stream, it's not going to go out. That's okay. I'm not upset about it, but I'm just wondering. From my days of pulling hose, you know. I know old style U.S. firefighters always use straight stream. And then thanks to a lot of inventive ideas and... That's not closing. There it is. He must have got him. He is. Go long distance beacon. I kind of figured that. And the Navy, believe it or not, we came up with the fog nozzles, which got very popular. They were like the go-to for quite a while. Okay. What do I got to do to pick these? There you go. I just had to stand just right. And then they kind of fell out of favor. And now many departments are right back to straight stream nozzle tip, which, you know, I've used both. Each one has its benefits and stuff. And, you know, as long as the fire goes out at the end of the day, it's whatever works the best. So we're headed back for the station, so it's a good time to cut away, as usual. We do have a little bit of time left, so keep your fingers crossed. And I'll talk to you when the bell goes off again. Well, hey, everybody. Man, I just seem to be having terrible luck getting good calls right now. And I don't want the waiting video to take too long because... then it takes forever to render, and my computer gets angry when that happens. So I'm going to go ahead and go to the call. This is the second oil spill in a row. We didn't have another call after that last one I talked to you about. Or actually, I take it back. We didn't have any good calls after the last one. I had another oil spill, and like... 2 minutes later, I had another, oil spill, for crying out loud. That must be a thing there. And so we'll wait for him to give me direction, which he will do. And, we'll sit here and watch this guy spread stuff on oil, because it seems to be the level of excitement that we're going to get today. That's okay. Oh, we had two spots of oil. That makes it three spots of oil. Triple threat. Holy cow. Not really, but what can you do? You make the most of what excitement you can get. I am the attack section leader, and I don't get to do a thing on this call. Except stand here and watch the show. So maybe in the system it rotates the personnel so at least it looks like they're doing something. I get it. So, but nothing broke. I actually snuck in and drove one of the vehicles back to the station. And took a shortcut just to make everybody mad. I was back in quarters and everything was taken care of, and the companies were still trying to get back to the station 2 or 3 minutes later. Nobody got mad. Nobody got upset. Nobody said a thing. They just went back on the step in between the kitchen and the patio and did the shuffle on the step, whatever that means. So anyway, let's wrap it up for this version. I don't know where he's going this time. That was different. I thought he was going to make a U-turn. Apparently not. Anyway, thanks again so much for coming by my channel. I really appreciate it. Like I said, you guys showing up, the stuff you leave on the channel as far as messages and questions and the comments, really make my day. Make it so easy to come here and do stuff for you guys. Whether it turns out to be anything exciting or not, I don't necessarily have 100% control over that, but it is what it is. So if you do have questions or comments about this particular video or the game itself, please leave them in the comments so we can get back to you on that. And if nothing else, say hi. I get a few of those every couple of days, and I kind of like, especially the ones that are in different countries and stuff. That's cool. If no comments, which is okay, at least a thumb up, thumbs up or a thumbs down to let me know whether I'm doing a good job or I need to reevaluate what I'm doing for you guys, because I want to provide the best content for you on this channel. Into that. Hope you're having a great day or a great evening wherever you are on the planet. Hope things are going the way you want. I know and you know we'll see each other in my next video, which I think is going to be 911 first responders, if I can get it all dialed in. And you guys take it easy.